remember me from the children's room, and I'm going to be showing you today everything that a kindergartner would typically learn here at Terry's. Now, we start off where they are, so they may have already dived into some of this, but for others, this will be new. So, let's begin. So, in the beginning, we go over this teamwork, the team board, just to make sure that it's packed solid and that they have it. And then once they learn their teams, they're going to be learning the names of those teams. So the words for 14, the word for 13, and so on. And then we then go on to the tens board. And here they learn that this is 1-10, so this gets 1-10. And then this is 1-1, and so it gets the red bead, and so on. So they find and they really get to see and manipulate these, where they see that it's 2-10s and 2-1s. Then we strive for them to learn 1 to 100 at least, and at Terry's they usually learn way, way more than that. So first, here's the hundreds board over here. I'm gonna go all the way over. Right there. First, they're going to do the underlay, which it shows all the numbers, and then they take away the underlay, and they try pre-sorted, where it's 1 to 20, then 21 to 40, every 20 numbers. And so then we go to the unsorted, where they have to take all of these numbers and put it on the hundred. And then once they've achieved that, we also then go into skip counting, where they see that it is right over here, where it's all of our chains, and it starts from 1 to 10, and they start to learn fives and tens first for skip counting. And then they go into the twos and threes and fours and sixes and sevens and eights and nines. And once they're able to do that fluently, then we go into cubes, which are over here. And they get to see that that chain makes a cube, well, makes a square first. And then when we get those stacked up, it becomes a cube. Then they go into the decimal layout, where they see that 1,111 is really 1,000 plus 100 plus 10 plus 1. So part of that is also expanded 4. And then they also are seeing that here's the 1,000 cube, but 10 of these equals this.
Called the exchange game.
Yes. And then 10 of these is equal to 1 of this, the 100. And then 10 of these are equal to this. So they're able to really see in exchange, seeing what each one does. Then they also learn about addition, 1 through 10 to start off with. And then we go into finding the missing add-in so that they can see what goes into making those two numbers, like 5 plus what equals 10. And then they're able to go into where they add like 70 plus 20, where you're not exchanging yet, but you're just adding those simply. And then eventually we get into exchanging, where you have the 8 ones and 5 ones. You have to add
another 10 bar to, yeah.
Oh, yeah, the ones from the ones to the tens.
So all of this is taken in small stages. We're kind of jumping around, yeah, showing you so many different skills that they're going to learn, right?
Yes, because it's a lot. And it does go throughout the year, so it may seem like a lot that I'm going through, but they learn this throughout the year. And then once they're able to exchange and they're able to show that each number is, if I tell them orally that 1,155, go get that, and they're able to bring that back with thousands, the hundreds, the tens, and the ones, we then go into the bank. This is called the bank game. And they put out a thousands, a hundreds, a tens, and a ones, two of those, and then they statically get to put out, right, static? Yes. And they add that 6,000 plus that 3,000. But I really emphasize that we start at the ones, because you never know what you may have to carry over.
By static, what we mean is when there is no carryover. So 5 and 3 is less than 10, so there's no carryover. And they start off again, we're really skipping around. We're adding the stamp game to the numerals. But if you look over here to these very concrete materials, those are the thousands cube, the 100 square, the 10 bar, and the unit bead. Those are what they use to make those very big numbers. So they may start off by going to go get 17 from the bank and bringing it back on a tray, and then 132 on the tray, and then 1,461 on the tray. And you keep giving them quantities to bring back, and then eventually you add those quantities together. And then this one that Ali is showing you is far more abstract. It's got little tiles with the numeral 1,000 on it that represent the bead material, the bank game material. So she's moving to something that they can do with paper. Big addition.
Yep, and right here is what they would write on, and start to really see that. They have the colors as well, where they use for ones, the green, tens, the blue, and red, the hundreds, and again, green for the thousands. So that way they're really able to see each number in its place value. That one. And then, to kind of change modes, we have them doing
some math concepts, right?
Yes, math concepts.
See that.
Where they're seeing greater than and less than. We start off smaller in the teens, and then we work our way up, where they're able to tell me whether this is a true statement or a false statement, and able to put them under the correct category. But here is the very basic, where we learn about the alligator wanting to chomp the greater number. And so you're able to see that visually, and I usually put out the amount of gems and imagine that they're cookies, or imagine that there's something that the alligator would want to eat, and they can see, oh, eat is bigger, so that is the greater number. Another math concept is money, where they learn about the penny, nickel, and dime, and they start to not only be able to tell me what it is, but then add them together. Add the pennies first, add the nickels first, and then dimes, quarters, and then start to add them all together. And our goal is to get up to over a dollar, but then being able to add it all together. And then another math concept is time to the hour and time to the half hour. And we try to get to even a quarter hour, but that is usually very difficult, but not impossible. So first, yep, we do that. The hour, and then the half hour, and then the quarter hour. About ounces, pounds, and tons, and which one would go under that, which is also a math concept. And then even in odd numbers, and there's really cool songs they get to learn about, and they might be learning about them now, but they're going to be learning about bigger numbers for odd and even, and being able to say why this is even and why this is odd more so than they are now. And then measuring in inches and centimeters, first doing that non, where we don't do inches, we just do like measuring in cubes or measuring in pencils or erasers, and then we go into the inches and centimeters, showing them that there's 12 inches in a foot, and showing them rulers and different kinds of things that we can measure with. We also do temperature, hot versus cold, saying, showing them that 68 degrees is actually pretty warm, but 35 degrees is pretty cold. And then being able to say, okay, that number is low, so it must be pretty cold. And that number is kind of high, so it must be a little bit warmer. And then finally, our fractions. They line up at one whole, one half, one third, and one fourth to begin off, and then we try to go into more. Then being able to see 3/4 and match it to the number 3/4. So we get to play, they get to play math bingo a lot, just so that, or fraction bingo, so that they can learn that, and they love it. Last year's class really loved it. And so overall, I taught Wyoming a couple of years ago, and when I taught kindergarten there, they learned mostly about the teens, and then there are sprinkles of time and money and weight and temperature. But all of this in the middle that we learn about is something that they don't learn. So that is a great opportunity for you guys, for your kiddos to learn and be here too. So this was great, and you learned a lot. Thank you.